In this video, we're going to find the bolt shear stress of a lap joint, which consists of two pieces of material that are overlapping. The lap joint is joined by a bolt, which is pictured on the left of the screen. We will also be finding the shear stress of a butt joint, which consists of three pieces of material. Two of the pieces are sandwiching the other, which is pictured on the right of the screen. Both of these joints have one bolt with a diameter of 10 millimeters going through it, and 900 newtons of tension force on the joint. To begin, let's review what normal stress is. Normal stress is when the material is either under tension or compression force. This means that if you were to take a cross-section of the material, the force would be acting 90 degrees perpendicular to the cross-sectional area, as pictured on this slide. Shear stress, on the other hand, is when the forces are acting parallel to the cross-sectional plane, as pictured on this slide. We will start by finding the shear stress of the bolt of the lap joint. The shear stress formula for a lap joint is force over the cross-sectional area of the bolt. So after we plug in our force of 900 newtons and the area of the bolt of 0.01 meters squared times pi over 4, we get an answer of 11.45 megapascals. Be careful to stay in the appropriate units. Now you're probably wondering, what happens if you have multiple bolts? If you have more than one bolt connecting the two pieces of material, you can simply divide the equation by the number of bolts. This is assuming that the bolts are sharing the load equally. Let's move on to the shear stress of the bolt in the butt joint example. We can use the formula tension force over 2 times the cross-sectional area equals the bolt shear stress. We divide the force by 2 times the cross-sectional area because there are two shear points sharing the shear load. After plugging in the tensile force of 900 newtons and 2 times the cross-sectional area, we get 5.73 megapascals for the shear stress on the bolt. Notice that this is half the value of the lap joint example. Once again, if you have multiple bolts, you can divide the answer by the number of bolts. This is assuming that the bolts are carrying the load equally. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Hopefully I've earned a like, share, or subscription. If you like this video, you may enjoy one of these videos as well.